Hi, I'm Teresa, and this is a love letter to my grandmother. Today, I thought I would make oatmeal cookies. I am pretty sure Grandma really liked oatmeal cookies. I counted 21 recipe cards for oatmeal cookies and 14 separate recipes for oatmeal cookies. 14. Clearly Grandma liked oatmeal cookies. So what I've done is I've gone through the different ones. We made the banana oatmeal a while ago, so that was one type that I know she liked, and she had 5 copies of that one. And what I picked today were called oatmeal drop cookies, and this is Edna's recipe. So we'll see. I've never had Edna's recipe that I know of. We'll see if this is a good one. it calls for 1 cup of butter, and I'm to cream the 1 cup of butter. So I've got my 1 cup of butter, and now I will cream it here. Okay, and then now that the butter is creamed, I need to add 1 cup of sugar. So I will do that and add that. So now that I've creamed the butter and the sugar, it says add the eggs. There are 2 eggs, so I'll do that. It actually says to beat the eggs in a separate bowl. Beat the eggs in a separate bowl. So I guess I will do that first. Okay, so we'll beat the eggs in a separate bowl. And then we are to gradually add the eggs, the milk, the oats, the raisins, and the walnuts. So you can see, there, here it is, creamed butter, sugar, and eggs. Next step is to add 1/3 cup of milk. Okay, so I've added the milk to my cookie dough, but now it seems more like a batter than a dough. And then I am to add the oats, which is 1.5 cups of rolled oats. I'll add that. And it has this gradually, so I'm gonna try and do it kind of slowly. Oh, I should say I am preheating the oven to 350 degrees as we speak. And then the next thing to do is to add 1 cup of raisins. And these are the lovely raisins that Eric grew and then made. Can't grow raisins ready, grew grapes, and then made them into raisins. So we'll add those. And then 1/2 cup of walnuts. So we have 1/2 cup of walnuts that we'll then add. And I know Grandma loved walnuts, so it's very important to have the walnuts in the cookies. So then it says, in a separate bowl, mix the flour, salt, cinnamon, cloves, allspice, and baking soda. So it's 1.5 cups of flour, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, which I've already mixed in there together. And then it's a half a teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of cloves, and 1/2 teaspoon of allspice. So I'll mix that in there, and we'll have a nice little mixture there of flour, spices, salt, and baking soda. Okay, so now that I've added that, I can then mix those, and pretty soon we'll be able to drop the cookies onto the cookie sheets. Very few of the cookie recipes that Grandma has are not dropped. There are a couple of refrigerator cookies, but otherwise they're mostly drop cookies. I've got my spoon. It's time to drop some cookies on our cookie sheets. We've got the beautiful little cooking mats that Kristen gave me, the Martha Stewart ones. Really awesome. Highly recommend them. And then these cookies, like most drop cookies, cook for 8 to 10 minutes. So I'm gonna take the first batch and put them in the oven, 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, our first batch of Edna's oatmeal drop cookies is about to come out. We have mere seconds until the timer goes off. 2, 1. Okay, here we go. Ooh, I think these look really good. Okay, so we're here, ready to do the taste test. They look really good.
Warm.
Mm-hmm. The best kind, right? Warm cookies. Ta-da. Mmm. I like them. How about you?
Come.
Mm-hmm. I think they have a good flavor.
Yeah, they're soft. Not heavy on oatmeal. So good oatmeal.
Mm-hmm. Cup and a half. I like them a lot.
They're good.
Mm-hmm. I think the raisins are the best part. Don't you?
It's all good.
Well, that's all for A Love Letter to My Grandmother. I'm Teresa.
I'm Eric.
See you next time. Bye.
Bye.